So working capital is also represented by a firm's net investments in current assets necessary to support its everyday business. Working capital frequently changes its form and is sometimes also referred to as circulating capital. This is, tawag nito. It is considered that it frequently changes its form because working capital, as we have mentioned a while ago, includes cash, accounts receivable, and usually inventory. So it changes from cash, from receivable to inventory, depending on what stage that the operation has taken into. And it can be explained mamaya sa baba, this one, but let us discuss it later na lang for us to do it step by step. So na yun. According to Getzenberg, circulating capital means current assets of a company that are changed in the ordinary course of business from one form to the other. Again, we'll be discussing that one later. So again, muna siya ang mga kasagaran sa mga current assets, cash, accounts receivable, inventory, current liabilities, accounts payable, short-term borrowings, and accrued liabilities. So, in this example, we have current assets of 80,000, current liabilities of 40. Therefore, our net working capital is 40. So, 80 minus 40. So, elements of working capital management. We have here that it involves monitoring of cash flows, asset and liabilities through ratio analysis. Na-discuss na po natin siya sa module 2 of key elements of operating expenses, including working capital ratio, collection ratio, as well as inventory turnover ratio. Efficient working capital management helps the company's smooth financial operation because a problem na gina-face kasagaran sa mga negosyante is that as they continue to operate, probably in 1 month or a year's time, they will find themselves nga mahutdan sila cash. Or let's say, dako na kayo ang ilahang kolektahon nun gikan sa ilahang mga customers kay sige sila pautang and kailangan nila kwarta wala sila ay makolekta. So those common problems maiwasan nun ta na siya if the management were able to perform capital working capital management as well as planning. Kung na situate na unta nila nga nakita na unta nila sa ilahang plano unta malikayan na to. Something like usahay daghang negosyante nga hilig kayo magpautang sa ilahang baligya for the sake nga mahalin, for the sake nga mawala sa ilahang inventory kay kalas kayo og space. Okay man po na siya, however, dili lang nato palabihan because basin moabot sa time nga kailangan na nato ang kwarta, di nato sila masangil and na incoming buyers nga willing mo bayad og cash. Problema, wala man tay inventory kay wala man tay kapangumpra. Wala pun tay ikumpra kay napautang nato tanan nato ang baligya. So again, if na plano na nato sa ahead of time, we could avoid those preventable disaster in our business. So efficient working capital management helps kada company's smooth financial operation and can also help to improve the company's earnings as well as profitability. So it involves management of accounts receivables, inventory, and payables. Working capital ratio is a key indicator of a company's fundamental financial health. This indicates the company's ability to successfully meet all of its short-term financial obligations. I don't know if you could still remember the current asset ratio and the acid test ratio. So current assets divided by current liabilities. We have discussed that one in module 1 man ata to. So the higher your current ratio or acid test ratio, the better, the higher is your capacity to pay for your short-term obligations. Kay daghan man kag current assets nga pwede nimo ibayad para sa imong current liabilities. Tapos tay ginatawag nga collection ratio. So collection ratio, also known as average collection period ratio, is a principal measure of how efficiently a company manages its accounts receivable. So the formula for this collection ratio is 365 days divided by your average accounts receivable turnover. So the higher the collection ratio is, the more detrimental it will be for the company. Kaya kaning magong collection ratio, kung mas dako siya, meaning mas dugay makolekta ang ato ang mga credit sales. Like for example, ang ato ang collection ratio is 20 days. Tapos ang as compared sa atong competitor nga 10 days lang. Meaning dugay kayo nato makolekta ang ato ang ginapautang. So the higher this collection ratio is, the tawag nito, mas lain sa on the part of our business kay wala man tayo kwartang magamit. So next one is we have inventory turnover ratio reveals how rapidly a company's inventory is being sold and replenished. So kaning ratio, it will tell us unsa ka paspas ginapatuyok sa isa ka company ang ilahang inventory. Kumbaga, marabag pag mangumpra sila, pag mahurot, kumpra na saan, hurot, kumpra na saan. So kung unsa ka paspas ang turnover within the year ang ilahang paggamit sa ilahang inventory. So the higher the turnover ratio is, the better for the company. For example, if the company has an inventory turnover ratio of 10, meaning na patuyok nila ang ilahang inventory ikanapulo during the year, which is to, depending on the business, will be good or bad depende sa unsa ang common practice or if i-benchmark nila sa mga competitor nila. So if ilang competitor is just having an inventory turnover of 5 tapos sila 10, then that company having the inventory turnover of 10 is doing better as compared to that nga 5 lang. So types of working capital, we have here the gross and net. The total of the current asset is known as the gross working capital. Whereas the difference between current assets and liabilities, current assets minus current liabilities, muna siya itong ginatawag nga net working capital. So the gross is the current assets. Permanent working capital, this is the minimum amount of working capital that must always remain invested. So again, it depends on the industry and the business. The goal of having this permanent working capital is that dapat natay policy as to pila sa ato ang current assets, cash, accounts receivable, inventory ang naka-invest sa ato ang operation. Kay kung daghan nakaayo tag cash nga nagtanggong na nasa dira, walay gamit, walay pulos, it's not earning money and basically it's useless. Kanang kwartaha nga wala naga-income, in a business perspective, useless kayo na siya. So as much as possible, we wanted to maximize our profit. Therefore, we have this permanent working capital that should be invested in the business, invested in our operation. Number three, variable working capital. These are variable funds that are drawn from short-term sources. So these are simply working capital or finances or kwarta nga ginagamit nato that came from short-term nga borrowings. So objectives of working capital, maintaining the working capital operating cycle and to ensure its smooth operation. Sama sa akong gidiscuss ganina, that we wanted to have this capital management because gusto nato nga magtuloy-tuloy ang atong operation. Nga dili na to gusto nga manirado ta tungod kay mahutdan ta og raw materials or manirado ta kay mahutdan ta ikapasweldo sa to ang mga trabahante. We do not want to that to happen. So in order for us to have this smooth operation, we need to plan and make sure that we are managing our capital. Of course, mitigating the cost of capital. Why? Kay siyempre, when we reach that point nga wala tay mahutdan ta og raw materials or wala tay kapasweldo sa ato ang mga trabahante, unsa may pwede nato buhaton, the fastest would be mangutang. And siyempre, kung mangutang ta, there is a corresponding interest. So in order for us to mitigate and minimize our cost of capital, katong interest nga atong ginabayaran, we wanted to avoid that or minimize it at least. So Again, capital management and planning would help us to do that. Maximize the return on current investment, asset investment. And syempre, if ma-minimize na to ang cost of capital, we are able to maintain and ensure smooth operation, tuloy-tuloy ang business, smooth ang atong operation, and therefore, ma-maximize na to ang atong investments. So, the working capital cycle. So, now we will be discussing katong ganina nga changing from one form to another. So, the working capital cycle refers to the minimum amount of time, take note of that, which is required to convert net current assets and net current liabilities into cash. So, mo ni siya ang cycle. Kaya, syempre, we will always be starting with cash na atay kwarta. Okay? So, kanang kwartahan na siya, ato na siyang ipalit og raw materials, ipang sweldo sa mga tao, pangbayad og rent, pangbayad og kurente, tubig, internet, blah, 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 in order for us to operate our business. So, after nato na siya ihatag sa itong mga creditors, suppliers, or sa itong mga ginagastosan, whatever it is, it would become inventory nga pwede nato ibaligya. Now, kanang inventory, it's either ibaligya nato siya on cash basis or on credit basis. That is why naanatay debtors, and hopefully, pag mamayad na ni siyang debtors, mabalik na po siya into cash. Then, kumpra na po nato, ibaligya na po nato, kumpra na po nato, ibaligya na po nato. And on and on and on with the working capital cycle. So, the faster this cycle is, the better for us because it will generate more profit. So, unsay component ani nga capital cycle? Of course, di na nato ni i-discuss. You already know what is cash. Creditors refers to the accounts payable. Okay, it also refers to the amount that has been paid to the supplier for the goods, purchase of goods or services. Kung natay avail nga services such as our employees as well as the purchase of raw materials. So, muna sa ang sa creditors. Sa debtors, refers to accounts receivable. Kay katong mga inventory na to, mga baligya na to, services na to, nga to ang ginapautang. Kung kinsa man itong mga nangutang, mo sila ang debtors, then hopefully, we are able to collect that one in the future. Inventory refers to the stock on hand. Again, akong gidiscuss ganina, pagbayad na to sa itong supplier, they will be delivering the inventory. Then the inventory will be sold and be converted to cash once more. So, please be reminded of that. This is very important. Again, the faster this is, the better for the business and the more profit for all of us. So, there are three approaches to this working capital cycle. If we wanted to go fast, we wanted to go slow, we wanted to be in between, it depends. So, conservative approach involves low risk and low profitability. In this strategy, apart from the permanent working capital, the variable working capital is also financed from the long-term sources. Now, this is conservative approach in a sense nga ang atong kwarta ginagamit came from long-term sources. And since long-term ni siya, yes, gamay lang ato ang monthly amortization nga ginabayaran sa ato ang loan, but we will be paying it for like 3, 5, or 10 years. So, the longer that we pay, the higher the total accumulation of our cost of capital. Okay? Gamay na siya noon og interest. Gamay na siya interest paminawon. Pero again, we will be paying it long term. That is why, cumulatively, if we total na ito na siya, mas dako siya compared sa short-term sources. Now, why would a company want to be conservative? Nga namang mangutang sa mga long-term sources? Because again, dili siya gusto nga dagko iyahang ginabayaran every month. That is why they prefer to have long-term sources. Okay? And at the same time, mas dako po dilahang pwede i-loan paging aning arrangement. And since mas dako ang loan, more cash para sa business, but lower monthly amortization. This means an increased cost of capital cumulatively. However, it also means that the risk of interest rate fluctuations are significantly lower. Okay? So we have also the aggressive one. So aggressive approach, the main goal is to maximize profits while taking higher risk. And by means of higher risk, higher interest bond. In this approach, the entire variable working capital, some parts of the entire permanent working capital are funded from short-term sources. Now, when we borrow short-term sources, like for example, on a monthly basis or a biannual or semi-annual basis, kadali lang kayo ta magbayad, but we will be paying for higher interest rates. Now, question. Nga namang kana nga to ang why would a business want to borrow on short-term basis nga na may mas dakong interest? Because we just wanted to pay interest for like 6 months. Then after that one, ginansa na tong uban. Wala na tayo bayranan. Kauban na guna sa nang nai uban mo palitay motor, gusto sila 3 years na po uban, gusto sila 6 months or 1 year lang. The mindset behind the 3 years because gamay lang ilahang monthly nga bayaran. Okay, so dili kayo bugat, wala kayo sila apason every month. Pero of course, they will be paying for it for 3 years. However, sa katong mga gusto mo palit og motor, tapos gusto lang nila bayaran for 6 months and 1 year, aggressive to siyang approach in a sense nga, yes, dag mag-apas-apas ko, mag-stress ko, magbinayad monthly, anak, kay dako man akong monthly. Pero after 6 months, after 1 year, wala na ko yung bayaran nun. I could move on to another project na pod. That is why it is considered aggressive approach. And sa business man po niya side, after nimo mabayaran ang imuhang loan to finance your business, then more profit will go into the business kaya wala naman ka-interest ginabayaran. So the earlier ka ma-impas sa imuhang utang, the better. And of course, there are those who have moderate or hedging approach. Involves moderate risk with moderate profitability. So, kung kato ganina, conservative, this one, ganina po, aggressive. So, any point between the two might be considered moderate. So, siguro, you will avail of short term, you will avail of long term, depende sa kung sa'y kailangan mo. So, it depends. It depends on you as a business operator. Whether you go conservative, pero low profitability, this one medyo high risk, high reward, or kaninga in between. So again, it depends. Significance of adequate working capital. So ano bang significance nito? Why do we even talk about this? Because adequate working capital ensures sufficient liquidity that ensures the solvency of the organization. Again, solvency is very important as well as liquidity. Liquidity primarily. Because in order for us to operate, there are short-term obligations or kanang ginatawag nato nga mga current obligations nato that we have to pay. Kaya kung dili nato na sila bayaran, we will stop operating. Sweldo sa ato ang mga empleyado. Bayad sa renta. Kaya kung di ka mo bayad og renta, tawaan ka dira. You cannot operate without electricity as well as water, especially kung restaurant business ka. Okay? Unsa man po'y paliton ni mo, unsa may kumpraho ni mo, unsa may ibaligya ni mo kung dili ka mangumpra. And unsa man po'y ikumpra ni mo kung wala kay kwarta. Especially, there are certain suppliers that requires cash. Okay? Working capital ensured prompt payment and on-time payments. It also includes the prompt payment and on-time payments to the creditors of the organization that helps build trust and reputation. Mangutang ka sa bangko because wala kay ikapinan sa imuhang business. Now, what if dili ka kabayad because nahutdan ka cash as you try to operate? Of course, your trust and reputation as a business person, as a business, will degrade in the long run, will decrease. Dili na sila musalig sa imo. That is why if you are deciding to expand, you cannot be financed by banks. kay kita man sa ilaha sa imong record dito nga oy kaning tawhanan eh kaning negosohan eh dugay kani mabayad dagan kani sa past due and dagan kani sa palusot or magtago-tago ni sa pagpaninglan na. Okay? A good credit history cannot only help an organization but to get fast approval but also can result in reduced interest rates. So there are those banks nga pag naka-build up ng trust and reputation, if you need additional funds, they would gladly offer you. Okay? So siguro sila pa mismo mo offer, oy basig kailangan pa nimo kwarta, magpautang pa mi. Okay? And at the same time, they might help you by giving you lower interest rates. Kay kabalo man sila nga kaning tawanan ni, mubayad yun ni. So even if gamay lang atong i-charge ayang interest sa ngalan nga makolekta yun na siya, makabayad yun na siya, then that's better kaysa sa maghatag og interest rates nga taas pero dili makolekta. What else? Adequate working capital ensures that dividends are regularly paid. So if you are a corporation that gives dividends to your owners or sa shareholders nimo, mas malipay ang mga shareholder kay nagabayad yung kag dividends. This also ensures an interrupted flow of production. So there are a lot of benefit by making sure that you are managing your working capital. Okay? So what's the importance? It's vital of a business and can provide the following advantage. Higher return on capital because you are managing it well. Seeing to it that your cost of capital is maintained low. Ensuring that tuloy-tuloy ang operation. Improve credit profile. So, mas plus points ka sa mga banko. Higher profitability as well. Higher liquidity. Increased business value. Favorable financing conditions. Uninterrupted production. And also the ability to face shocks and peak demand. So, excuse me. When we talk of ability to face shocks, kana bang in case na yung mga emergency, unwanted nga mga mahitabo, dili ka makurat-kuratan, dili ka malubat-tubatan because nakapangandam ka eh nakay buffer, nakay baga, nakay emergency fund. Unlike sa urban business nga mag-operate 0-0, what I mean is ang ilang i-collecta, igura po't ibayad, so wala yung mabilin nga cash on hand, just in case nga mo cash advance ang ilang trabahante or na emergency, wala. Kailangan na nila mangutang. So, bayad na po'y interest. And overall competitive advantage. Kanipod, peak demand. What if na yung mag-bulk order sa inyo ha? Kung restaurant ka or, butang na nato, you are engaged into food business tapos all of a sudden ay nag-order og 1,000 ka order nya kay kulang man imong supply so mabalibaran to nimo pero na sana naging bato pa because again poor working capital management. Cash flow management is the term used to describe the practice of balancing income to expenses in terms of cash. It entails the movement of funds in and out of the business and this information should be tracked on weekly, monthly, quarterly. I think na-discuss naman siguro nato ni sa module 1. Okay? Positive cash flow means cash coming into the business, of course, by means of sales, by means of accounts receivables. So, mas daghan ang nagasulod, mas better. Hanar na siya. So, how do we address cash short? So, there are really times that no matter how good we are in management, time will come nga mahutdan yung tag-cash. Or not necessarily mahutdan, pero limited ang atong cash or makulangan atong cash. Okay? So, unsay pwede nato buhaton? So, these are some suggestions. Mangutang, okay? Apply for a loan. If ever na makulangan ka kwarta, you apply for loan. Problema lang if you're a small business without any credit rating, kisa may magpahulam sa imo. Mabitaw nang there was a businessman nga nagtambag sa ako ang I mean, niingon siya ba nga dili ka sani? You're not a true businessman kung dili ka mangutang. Because for most businesses, their operation and their business is funded by utang. So by having a positive credit profile, kana bang ang imong credit rating sa mga bangko is taas. Okay, taas sila trust sa imo, taas sila confidence sa imo. That is actually an asset. Okay, kay pag mga apply kag loan, magpautang man dayon sila. Because again, nahanak kay nangutang na ka before and nakabayad ka on time per minute. So apply for a line of credit from banking institution. So aside from loan, kay kaning loan naman siya interest. There are also times wherein natay ginatawag nga line of credit. So the better your credit reputation is, the higher your line of credit. Meaning, mas dako kag mautang sa mga bangko kung goods ang imuhang reputation sa ilaha. Speed up the collection process. So if mahutdan kag cash, guys, tapos daghan kay kag accounts receivable, parehas atong activity ganihin na 55 something ang iyahang 55 million ang iyahang kailangan pero 27,500 lang ang iyahang cash pero nasa 40 million nga receivable. So, speed up the collection process. Paningil. So that, nga kay cash gamiton. Finance the purchasing of equipment through leasing or loans. So, instead nga, paliton nimo cash ang imuhang mga equipment. Sa pool, palit sa kanan, palit yung mga appliances for the business. Instead nga, i-cash nimo na siyang palit, kaya gusto ka makabarato, why not consider installment payments? So that katong kwarta nga nasa imo karon matago nimo just in case na kay bayaran magamit nimo. Okay? And at the same time you also have the equipment secured because on installment basis man siya. Liquidate assets. So kung naka yung mga assets diha ang away gamit, pwede ibaligya. Benta mo na so that you have the cash to be utilized. And the last payments from vendors. Hangyoan mo, imong mga vendors, imong mga creditors nga sunod na lang kabayad because nakigamitan. Again, musugot lang na siya kung goods ang imuhang reputation as a businessman. That is why kung ikaw tabag ka kang negosyante, dugay kay kang mubayad, nya pala utang kay ka, sooner or later, wala na dyan mutuo sa imuha and bye-bye ka. Paphad yung negosyantiha ka. So, maximizing use of projected cash surpluses. In some cases, an organization may expect a revenue surplus and a cash flow. What the company does with that money can affect future opportunities. Which means that money shouldn't be spent or left sitting around. Mani kong ingon ganina nga itong minimum ay required or permanent working capital. A company should have a policy kung pila dapat ang ibutang sa ato ang operation and pila dapat lang ang mabilin. Kaya kung naay sobraan na, anong gagawin natin dyan? Dili na siya nato patulugon. We would not want our cash sitting around. So dapat natay mga projection as to saan nato ang mga sobra-sobra na itong akwarta. For some businesses, ang inabuhat nila is they invest it in stock markets. Napoy uban nga mag-branch out sila. Napoy uban nga magpalit sila ng additional equipment. So, it depends. Also, accounts receivable management. Muna na siyang gingon ako ganina nga if you're the type of businessman nga kusog kayo magpautang for the sake nga taas ang imuhang sales pero maot kayo imuhang policy on collection, time will come that it will hunt you in a sense nga wala kay kwarta, daghan ka kolekta ho nun, pero di nimo makolekta. So what could you do? Number one, before a company grants credit to a customer, it should ensure as far as possible the customer is worthy of that credit. Man ang ginatawag nila nga CI, credit investigation. Before nato pautangon ng customera ni, we need to investigate whether naa ba siya capacity. Kay kung ingon na siya, kay kung atong pangutan na siya nga, kaya ba ni mong bayad? Siyempre, mutando. Yes, kaya na ko mabayad. But, aside from that, we have to do our investigation. Once the decision has been taken to credit, then suitable credit terms must be set. And receivables authorized must be monitored efficiently. Maabitaw nang naay ginatawag ng mga rebates. Para asa mo ng rebates? For the char lang, dili. Rebates are being utilized in order for prompt payments. Kumbaga, it encourages borrowers to pay on time or earlier, because they want to avail of those rebates. For example, ang motor na mo, 4,000 pesos, tapos na yung rebates nga 200. So, instead nga 4,000 imong bayaran, 3,800 na lang kaysa yung mga nagbayad. You're availing yourself of that 200 pesos of rebates. Napoy uban nga, pag malit kang bayad, na kay penalty, na kay surcharge. So, as a borrower, we do not want to pay penalty, so magbayad tag sayo. And of course, we need to monitor. There are also companies nga 5 days or 3 days before due date, ilang ginatexan, ginatawagan ng ilahang customers so that ma-remind sila. Kaya na dyan times na nga makalimot ang ating bayad na day. So, if you will be able to remind them, maka-avail sila rebates, maka-avail, dili sila kabayad ng penalty, and encourages them to pay on time. A key area of management of accounts receivable is the final collection of cash from customers. Any company must have a rigorous system to ensure that all customers pay in a timely fashion. Muna ito kung discuss ganina, dagan silang, dagan tag pwede buhaton as businessmen in order to manage our accounts receivable. Okay? One and another thing na pwede nyo mabuhaton is to have multiple modes of payment. Pwede ka bayaran through cash, pwede ka bayaran through Palawan, ML, RD Pawnshop, GCash, Paymaya, PayPal, or basta dagang pwede ibayad sa imo. Because if, especially if you are engaging in online business, nga dagan na pong tao ang naay nagagamit og mobile banking, so much better nga dagang silang paagi para mabayaran ka. Kaya kung through Palawan-Palawan lang, kapoy na igawas, dagang tao po sa Palawan. So, sale na unta to, sa imo na unta to mo palit, but since kailangan pa man ni mo sila pa doon sa Palawan Pawn Shop, then ngita lang sa laglain seller. Inventory management. Management refers to the process of ordering, storing, and using company's inventory. This includes the management of raw materials, components, and finished products. So we're now in the management of inventory. This is a collection of interdisciplinary processes that includes a full circle from supply chain management to demand, forecasting to inventory control, and including reverse logistics. So when we talk of supply chain management, this refers to our suppliers, our inventory, the cycle kung sa ginagian sa ato ang supplies. So the better it is, the smoother it is, the better for our business. Muna siya. Supply chain management, inventory control, demand forecasting, as well as reverse logistics. So, inventory management starts and ends with supply chain management because many of the opportunities to improve efficiencies starts with shortening order to receipt time. So, the faster it is, the shorter the period of this supply chain management, the better for us. Kana bang layo pa, I mean, dili pa ka mahotdan og supply na forecast na nimo daan niya pag abot na gani ani nga level ang akong inventory, dapat mag-order na ko. So dapat sa gikan sa akong pag-order hantod sa pag-abot sa akong inventory, shorter lang ang period of time so that ita mahotdag stock, dili ta ma undang sa ato ang operation. That is why natin ginatawag nga economic order quantity. It's the order quantity of inventory that minimizes the total cost of inventory management. We also need to minimize the total inventory cost, and the EOQ model helped us to do that. Okay? If you're engaged into retail business nga nag-buy and sell ka og mga gamit or products, we do not want to order daghan kay. Di ta gusto nga daghan kay itong orderon. Kay basig mapuno ang atong warehouse, mapuno ang atong bodega, nya dili di ay mahalin. Dili po ta gusto nga gamay lang pod kaayo ang ato ang orderon nga maabot sa point nga mahutdan ta and naapay mangita. So gusto nato nga tamang-tama lang. And that is why natay EOQ. Economic order quantity, sorry, na ECQ. This should be EOQ. So how do we compute EOQ? So EOQ is this one, square root of 2 multiplied by DS divided by H. So ang component aning ato ang EOQ are the following. We have the ordering cost, we have the holding cost, as well as the muna sa ordering cost, holding cost. And unsa kadaghan ang ato ang palitonon. So example, ABC company is engaged in sale of footballs, bola. Its cost per order is 400. So kada mag-order ta og bola, okay, kada mag-order ta, natay bayaran niya 400. So it is like ordering sa Lazada or sa Shopee, tapos ang shipping cost is 400. So for whatever order it is, mapadaghan, mapagamay, 400 na siya. Carrying cost is 10 per unit per annum. Unsa man ang carrying cost? Kaning carrying cost is the cost per unit per year that pertains to its storage cost. Kumbaga, na kay bodega. Take for example, ang imong bodega is ginarentahan nimo. Or if na kay bodega sa inyong balay pero limited lang. So, mauna sa ang projected cost nga magasto sa isa ka unit sa pagstay sa imuhang bodega for 1 year. Okay? Meaning, we do not want to have an inventory nga magtambay lang dira for the next 1 year tapos dili siya mahalin. Okay? So, we also wanted to minimize this one. We do not want nga ang atong inventory dili mahalin. So as much as possible, kadali lang dyan na siya magstay sa atong bodega. And the cost of that inventory staying in our bodega na dili mahalin is 10 pesos per unit per annum. I hope na sometime na sa. If wala, please make sure to comment sa baba so that I could read and I'll be able to answer. The company has a demand for 20,000 units. So ato na sa itong formula, EOQ is equals to 2 times the delivery cost, the 400, times the demand for the units, 20,000, divided by the carrying cost of 10. So, muna siya. Square root of 2 times 20,000 times 400 divided by 10. So, the answer is 264.90 something. Or 265. So the economic order quantity or the optimum number of units na ato ang dapat order it is 265. So kada order na po nato 265 na siya dapat. So if we will be so 20,000 man no, per year. So i-divide na to sa 265. Kaya 265 man ang atong order on kada order, it will lead to a 15.8 or 16 orders per year. So, the optimum number of order is 265 units. And since 20,000 man atong kailangan per year, that amounts to a 12 orders per year. Okay? I hope nasabtan, no? So, since ika-16 man ta, mag-order ka na tuig, nya times 400, ordering cost or the delivery cost, ang magasto na nato for the delivery is 6,400. Okay? And ang atong average inventory held is 1,265 man, average na to na siya, 632 units, tapos times 10, our carrying cost is only 6,325. So, plus the 64 for the ordering cost, our total operating cost in relation to inventory ordering is only 12,725. Any higher or lower than the 1,265 will result to more expenses. Example, what if instead of 1,265, ang atong orderon lang is 1,000. Okay, sample lang. So, what if 1,000 lang? So, 20,000 divided by 1,000. So, 20. So, 20, multiply na itong 400 sa ordering cost, that will result to 8,000. So, and another is, since 1,000 man na ito ang gina-order, kada order, average na ito na siya, 500 multiplied by 10. So, that is 5,000. 5,000 for the carrying cost, 8,000 for the holding cost. So, 8,000 plus 5,000, that's 13. 13 versus our EOQ na 1,265 is only 12,725. Ginansado pataog, 275. Now, what if instead of 1,265 and instead of 1,000, 1,500 ang ato ang orderon? Or 2,000 na lang para dili bungkig. 2,000 units kada order. So, 20,000 divided by 2,000. So, instead of 16 orders per year, 10 orders per year lang. So, times 400, 4,000 lang ato ang ordering cost. And since 2,000 man ato ang gina-order, average of that is 1,000 multiplied by 10. 10,000 ang atong carrying cost plus the ordering cost of 4,000. So that's 14,000 as compared to 1,275. So mas barato gyapon pag EOQ ang atong gamiton. If you wanted to experiment, let's say 1,500 or 1,300 ang inyong gusto, feel free to do so. But then again, I am assuring everyone na ang pinakagamay dyan na nga cost is the EOQ. 1,265. Okay? So, again, we have here the application. I'll be sending this one as well. Butang na ako sa description. And that would be all for this lesson.